He is not angry about the coverage, but he does disagree with two things about it.
I never used the word demanded. That's very clear. By what authority or right would I have to demand? And number two, in the context of the story where they say that it would reveal the real killers, well, no, that's for television. That's for Jack Klugman and Quincy and CSI.
Other than that,
I've been saying these things, Sally, for 47 years, going back to 1965 when I first started with the JFK case.
Theories disagreeing with the Warren Commission. Theories about bullet holes and another shooter besides Lee Harvey Oswald. And he thinks articles like this keep that fresh.
Yes, I think that it will stir up interest. The answer to the second question, do I think it will result in anything with the family? No.
And actually, the Examiner article is basically a rewrite of another article in the Examiner's sister publication, The Globe. Donna Kaufman, who wrote two books with Wecht, wrote it in March, basing it on Wecht's 1993 book, Cause of Death.
She knew nothing about the National Examiner article herself until I called and told her.
The National Examiner with the Wecht article is now off the newsstands, but Dr. Wecht fully expects the discussion of his theories about the Kennedy assassination to continue, and he doesn't mind if it's in the tabloids. The
tabloids are read by millions of Americans, and to simply denigrate their existence because they engage in sensationalism, it doesn't mean that the things that they write about and the stories that they depict are not things sometimes that are of interest and sometimes of timely concern.
And next year in October, Dr. Wecht says the Cyril Wecht Institute of Forensic Science and Law at Duquesne University will host the country's largest JFK conference in America, 1 month before the 50th anniversary of the president's assassination. Sally Wiggin, Channel 4 Action News.